Hey guys, and welcome back to another video of DeLady's Studios. And I know the Ghostbusters DLC is finally released this week, and I wanted to upload way earlier. Maybe you have read it on my community wall, like I got the flu this week, that's why I still sound maybe a little bit of having a cold. But yeah, so we're back a little bit later than planned, but it's all gonna be fine. And I haven't really started building with the Ghostbusters pack yet, because I noticed that I totally forgot to upload this speed build. So we're first going to do this, and then I start building with the Ghostbusters pack. And I really wanna see if I can make some kind of dark ride maybe with the Ghostbusters DLC. I mean, that totally fits in DeLady's Studios. So yeah, I think that's definitely something we can do. But first things first, we have the vintage pack, and we have that lovely little pier at DeLady's Studios. And I just really wanted to do something with the vintage pack. Now there is like a huge building pre-made in the blueprint section, and I used that one as a lot of inspiration for this, because I had no idea what I could else use for inspiration. So I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna do that and try to make a cute little plaza. The only thing I forgot to do, which is not really something I would forget, is the fronts of the shop to decorate them. So you will notice in the end cinematic shots that I totally forgot to do the decoration of the shops itself. So I'm sorry for that. I know that I realized it when I was looking at these footages, and I was like, oh no. What else I did do, I tried, like we spoke about it in the last Planet Coaster video, or at least one of the last speed builds episode, I did talk about if I want to make a zoo or not in Planet Coaster, and I still haven't figured it out. I started recording an entrance for a zoo, just a small one, just to get like in the mood for Planet Zoo, but I still haven't figured out if I want to. Like, there are not that many animals made with the Themaker's toolkit. So I feel like I'm a little bit restricted, is that the right word, to work with that. Like, we do have a lot of animals in the adventure pack and in the spooky pack, so I think we can get pretty far, but there's also a thing that I just want to work with, like animals that are not maybe in the game, but I want to make enclosures for that, but then it feels so empty. So that's why I so much have my doubts of, do I want to do this or not? Like, we do have the Zoo Tycoon series we've got going on Saturdays during a live stream, which is a lot of fun. Like, the last live stream where you tried to make an underwater enclosure. So that was the first try, and it does work out, but I still have to work on my skills, obviously, to decorate everything and stuff. But it's really interesting to see what you can do with the Zoo Tycoon 2 pack. And also really frustrates me that some kind of things like an underwater viewing area, you just can't build that in Planet Coaster right now, which we can do in Planet Zoo, which I'm super excited about. But that's also a thing that is holding me back, because I really want to play with the water section. So yeah, I'm just not really sure if I want to release anything like that for a Planet Coaster series, because we can do so many things in Planet Coaster, but like the water sections, that's going to be my favorite thing of all times in Planet Zoo. I'm going to use that a lot, and I just don't know. It's just something I just can't do if I want to make a zoo in Planet Coaster. So I don't know. What do you guys think about that? I'm just really curious how you guys feel about that. And are you enjoying the Zoo Tycoon series that we've got going on? I really have a lot of fun with that, and it's also really nice to chit chat with you guys. So if you haven't seen it yet, please go and check it out, or maybe just join us on a Saturday. It's a lot of fun, just a chill stream. So I really enjoyed that. So everyone that is there already, thank you guys so much for your amazing support, because I really do enjoy hanging around with you guys. I really love that. So yeah, Planet Coaster, we're doing a lot of decorations right now at the building section, and I think in the end, it looks okay. I still feel that something is missing, but I think in the end, if you see like the building from further away, it looks pretty good with the pier in front of it. So yeah, we're just gonna keep it for now. I'm still debating if I wanna remove or maybe move the World's Fair areas of the Lady Studios to a different area, because I just don't know. I think the next episode, if we're going to start a Ghostbusters ride, we might delete it or just move it to some other place, but I really wouldn't have no idea yet where I could put down those Bavarian and Chinese street. So we have to wait and see about that. But I think DeLady's Studios is coming along quite nicely, so I really hope you guys enjoy that too. Also, I'm really curious, like, how many people of you did already play the Ghostbusters story mode, and what do you think about it? I haven't really got a chance to do it because I wanted to make a series out of it, but then I got the flu. So yeah, after a few days, I made a poll on my community wall, like, what do you guys want me to do now? Because I feel that a lot of YouTubers and streamers already played the story mode, so is it still a thing to record it for you guys? Would you still enjoy watching it? I honestly have no idea, because I can also imagine that if you have bought the pack, you've already played it, so why would I even bother to record it for you guys? So then, I need to find some time to play it myself, I guess, because I don't want to miss out on it. So yeah, that's the only reason I still haven't played it yet, because I wasn't sure if you guys want me to record it or not. So do let me know in the comment sections if you would enjoy me playing some Ghostbusters DLC. It was really fun just to see what was in the pack. I was so amazed by the amount of pieces. That's crazy. I think we have like 4 or 5 wall sets in there, and like a decoration set for your dark rides and stuff. So that's really awesome. And I was really surprised to see how many pieces we got. Like we went to the Frontier office last week, but it wasn't like the Frontier developers put down all the pieces for us, like, oh, look at that, we have more than 400 pieces. No, they didn't. They mostly spoke about the story mode, and they showed us some stuff from the story mode, so we had no clue that there were so many pieces in there. So with the review, I was honestly super surprised about the amount of pieces in the pack. So yeah, I can imagine that a lot of people are really excited about that. And obviously the dark ride itself, the shooting ride, it's just really awesome, and I love the fact that you can also play it yourself. If you haven't seen it, I posted like a POV of the ride they made in the game, and it's really a lot of fun. So yeah, I definitely want to do something with that, with the park. So in the end, if we complete the park and I upload it to the workshop, you guys can also play the game and then have like your high school. It will be awesome if you could see all the names of your friends, but I don't think it works like that. I do think you can only see your name and like the guests that are in your park, so you can beat them, but I think that's the only one, but I'm not really sure about that. But that will be really cool if you have your Steam friends or anything and then all play the same game and then can see the high score. That will be really funny though. So yeah guys, I really hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Please do let me know, what do you think of my video obviously, but also of the Ghostbusters DLC, and if you have played the story mode, what do you think about the story mode? I'm really curious to hear about that. And my name is the Lady Designer, by the way, for those who don't know. And please make sure to subscribe, of course, if you already haven't, and leave a like at the video. It's really, really a lot appreciated, and it really helps the channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. Enjoy the rest of the video, and I hope to see you tomorrow, by the way, with the Planet Zoo E3 announcement. I am definitely going to tell you more about everything we know about the Planet Zoo game coming up. It's going to be really excited, to make sure to tune in tomorrow evening around the time of E3. Make sure to be there, and hopefully I can surprise you guys. Thank you guys so much. Hope to see you tomorrow, and also in another video. Bye guys.